Can you guys hear me? Let's try this. Can you guys hear me?
Okay, seems to work. There's only three person. I thought there would be less. Okay, so let's start. I did a bit of research before starting the live stream. I actually did a lot of research before starting, and there is so many classes in D&D that I did not know. And by the way, I am using homebrew classes too, because otherwise there won't be as much fun with just the regular one. And let's start with the most obvious one, which is Soundwave class, which I think is obviously a bard. I mean, do I really need to explain why? And I did find this subclass called Audiomancer, and I'll show you guys what I found out about it. Yeah. So, this spell casting is... you have to learn to bend the nature of sounds and harmonies to your will and can channel powerful magic from this. If this isn't a Soundwave thing, I don't know what is. And there is some other spells that also sounds exactly like Soundwave abilities, but I'm not being here. I'm not going to read them all, so otherwise I will be here forever. Oops, wrong thing. Okay. Next one, who was also very easy to figure out, is Perceptor, which I think is an artificer. I know that probably Wheeljack will be a better artificer than Perceptor, but there isn't a better class than artificer for him. And I didn't find this subclass that is called Constructor. It indeed is an homebrew, obviously. This one. Basically, Constructors seem to have some sort of orbs made out of metal that they can tinker with, obviously enough, and then transform into weapons or anything that can help them in battles. But I guess it can also be used for anything they want to, which in this case would work perfectly as Perceptor scope, since he's blind, they goddamn idiot. And yeah, this is mainly why I decided that this subclass was right for him. Next one is wasn't exactly easy, and I'm still not sure about it, and it's Whirl, which I made him a tinkerer. Now, tinkerer seems to have something in particular with the clockwork and clocks in general, and I know that this version of Whirl, the Cyberverse version of Whirl, was it a clock, what's it called? A design clocker? I don't know what they call it. Like the EDW one, EW one. But I thought it would be a nice sort of nudge towards the original Whirl. And I also found that he has this ability like craft explosive, which really sounds like a weird thing, and clockwork fiddling, another thing that just made me think of Whirl. So yeah, it probably doesn't fit him precisely, but it's the best one I could find. And then we have another one who was actually quite easy to find, Hot Rod, a paladin. And paladin, from what I read, they are extremely loyal, and he is royal to the Autobots and his friends, but apparently they can also use spells and abilities, which made me think of the flames the Hot Rod can sometimes use. So I think it might work for him. I didn't look for a subclass. There's definitely is a subclass that will fit precisely Hot Rod, but I didn't want to find him. I don't know, I thought maybe it's a bit of cliche for him to be a paladin, but again, did not find anything better than that. And then, hold on 1 second, I'm trying to look something up. There we go. Clobber. Initially, I want to make her a barbarian, but I remember that barbarian takes strength precisely, especially from the rage, which I don't think it's a Clobber thing. I don't think I ever see her angry. Frustrated, maybe, but angry, no. Or mad, even. So I instead made her a fighter with the other subclass that I found, always homebrew, which is the Juggernaut, which is... Hold on. Maybe there are too many commands on this goddamn computer. So a Juggernaut, a master of strength and defense, a warrior who aims to block attacks, taunt enemies, and drop war with their shield. And consider how big Clobber is and how strong she is, I think this fits her perfectly. Especially because, let's face it, she will defend her friends like there's no goddamn tomorrow. So it sounds perfect. She's basically a tank. Well, she is a tank, I guess that's the hard mode. Her alt mode, I guess. And then, last but not least, Deden is the one that gave me the most trouble. I could not, for the love of me, find a good enough class. But I did find a homebrew class, which is just so wild, to be honest, but I guess it fits him, which is a dark weapon. Now, I don't know if it's a thing in Cyberverse. I don't know if there are Combacticons in Cyberverse, combiners in Cyberverse, but so far we didn't really have anything that said otherwise. So let's just think as that end as the Stanticon that is. And what a dark weapon is, basically, is... where's the specific parts? Oh, here we go. In exchange for their loyalty, the Hugs bestow upon them the ability to take on the forms of weapons. Now, it did say in the more larger version of this that they also can change into anything that is weapon-based. And I guess that being part of a combiner, I don't know exactly which part that end is, but I guess that being a part of a combiner will make you a weapon. So, this is the best I could find, guys. Don't hate me, please. This is the best thing I could find, and I could not, for the love of me, find anything else. I did try with another subclass, not subclass, homebrew class, who was called, what was it? Bodyguard? Arcane Bodyguard, something like that. Which basically is a fighter loyal to... I forgot what it was, but I think this dark weapon thing just suits him better. And while I was also researching for a reference for all the classes, I decided that instead of going with the classic D&D styles, the classic sort of medieval style, I will try to kind of mix modern and cyberpunk. It's gonna be hard because I never draw in cyberpunk things, but I will try. And I will 100% make them humans. I'm not gonna choose a race like, I don't know, Goblin, Orc, Elf. Otherwise, I'll be here for a year, and I don't have so much time at disposal. So they're all going to be humans. Oh, well, I could try to make Clobber enough. Otherwise, I'll change my mind every goddamn second. So I'm going to mute myself now, but questions are welcome, suggestion as well. And let me do this for a second. Okay. Yeah, I'll do my best to try and just start with Hot Rod. It should be the easiest one out of all of them. Let's see how it goes. Let's hope it goes well.